Hello, Pirates. Today is Wednesday, January 12th, and I'm Vinny Chavez with your Pirate News.
Good morning, Pirates. Karen Martinez Vega here. Do you know anyone who will be a future Pirate next year? If so, PCHS is hosting an incoming freshman night scheduled for January 12th beginning at 5:30 p.m. in a small gym. Not only will it be an informational event preparing current 8th graders for their high school registration, but it will also be filled with fun activities, including a pep rally and having pizza with your future principal, Mr. Long. This is a great chance to learn more about our school's academic programs and extracurricular activities, meet new people, and get to explore campus. Plus, attendees also receive free entrance to girls' basketball game beginning at 7 p.m. If you're interested in this event, mark your calendars for Wednesday, January 12th. Port Charlotte High School awaits you and gives you a warm welcome. This is Karen Martinez Vega signing off. Thank you.
Hey Pirates, I'm Lily here with upcoming athletic events. Today, January 12th, we have track practice at Murdoch Middle School at 4 p.m., a home varsity girls basketball game versus Lakewood at 7 p.m., varsity's boys soccer at Venice 7:30 p.m., and for tomorrow, Thursday, January 13th, we have track practice at Murdoch Middle School at 4 p.m., wrestling regionals to be announced, boys basketball versus Lehigh, JV starting at 5:30 and varsity starting at 7.
The newest installment of Spider-Man released on December 17th and has received positive reviews from almost every critic. Fans around the world gathered to view the new No Way Home movie. Don't worry if you haven't seen it yet. There are no spoilers here. The movie begins with Spider-Man's identity being revealed by Mysterio out to the world, putting everyone he knows in danger. Peter Parker frantically tries to figure out how he could fix everything, until he realizes that he needs Doctor Strange's help. This leads to a whole mess with reality causing a little thing called the multiverse to open up. With the multiverse open, multiple villains such as the Green Goblin and Dr. Octopus try to fight Spider-Man. Although instead of trying to fight them, this time Spider-Man has to work with them to get them back into their own realities. In my opinion, this movie is absolutely amazing. This movie captures the true way Spider-Man was meant to be perceived. He's a superhero, yet he still makes many mistakes, and although he makes mistakes, he still tries to fix them. Worldwide audience agree. Despite a raging pandemic, this newest installment in the Marvel movie machine is already the sixth highest grossing movie of all time, and expected to move up at least one more spot after the coming weekend. We rank this movie as a treasure.
Hi Pirates, I'm Sarah Peabody and I'm here with a college sports update. On Monday night, legions of college football fans crowded around TV sets to see who would be crowned the national champions. The final teams left standing in the playoffs were both SEC teams who had already played each other just 37 days before Alabama, which has dominated college football for a decade and whose coach has won 7 national titles, and the University of Georgia, who haven't held the title since their win way back in 1980. Georgia lost the game 37 days ago and entered the championship as a slight underdog. The game was a close-fought match for the most of the contest, with neither team scoring a touchdown until late in the game. But then Georgia's quarterback, Stetson Bennett, who has electrified fans ever since his status as a walk-on athlete, fumbled at the beginning of the fourth quarter. This allowed Alabama to take an 18-13 lead with a 10-14 left. But on the very next possession, Bennett stopped making mistakes and went 4-for-4 for 83 yards and 2 touchdowns. The play that officially ended the game was the pick 6 for Keely Rango, who intercepted the ball and ran it back 79 yards for a final Georgia touchdown to end the game. The Georgia Bulldogs finished with a score of 33 to Alabama's 18 and won the national title in an upset victory.
Hello Pirates, my name is Jacob Batt and welcome back to another edition of This Day in History. On this day exactly 12 years ago, a magnitude 7 earthquake devastated the Caribbean island of Haiti. This earthquake killed over 200,000 people and left a million injured or homeless. This earthquake touched off a massive international relief effort. The earthquake was believed to have originated along the same fault line as the devastating tremor 11 years prior. This earthquake was just one more of the many disasters that Haiti was facing, including political, economical, and social setbacks and inequalities.
Happy Wednesday. This is Damaris with the weather. Thursday will be a partly cloudy day with a high of 72 and a low of 48. Friday will be a sunny day, high of 71 and low of 44 degrees. This weekend, it's going to be seasonably chilly, with Saturday having a high of 73 and a low of 57. And Sunday will feature a high of only 68 and a low of 47 degrees. Enjoy those cooler temps, Pirates!
Hi Pirates, I'm Caitlin. Welcome back to the Big Brain Trivia Challenge.
I'm not a smart man.
Welcome to the Big Brain Challenge. Information guaranteed to blow your mind.
I am the smartest man alive!
The question of today is, what was the first soda to be in space? A. Sprite, B. Coca-Cola, C. Pepsi, D. Fanta. The answer is Coca-Cola. Coke became the first soda drink to be consumed in outer space when the astronauts aboard the Space Shuttle Challenger tested the Coca-Cola space can on July 12, 1985.
I'm Vinny Chavez with your joke of the day. Why do we tell actors to always break a leg? Because every play has a cast.
That's it for today's broadcast. See you next time for more Pirate TV.
The best news on the seven seas!
I got my driver's license last week, just like we always talk about. Cause you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house. But today I drove through the suburbs crying cause you